श्री गुरुवे नमः। ओके, नाउ लेट्स कंटिन्यू द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन। एंड सडनली बोली नोटिस दैट द टीचर वॉज स्टैंडिंग बाय हर साइड स्माइलिंग एट हर। व्हाट्स योर नेम लिटिल वन? बो बो बो। शी कुड नॉट स्टैमर नो फर्दर दैन दैट। एंड आफ्टर सीइंग दोज कलरफुल पिक्चर्स ऑन द वॉल शी देन रियलाइज्ड दैट द टीचर वॉज स्टैंडिंग नियर हर। एंड द टीचर has asked her to say her name. She started saying her name, Bo Bo. She could not say more than that. Then she began to cry. The tears flowed from her eyes in a helpless flood. She kept her head down as she sat in her corner, not daring to look up at the girls who she knew were still laughing at her. And in fear, then she started to cry and she bowed her head down and sat in a corner, and she had no courage to look up at the girls who she knew that they were laughing at her all the time. When the school bell rang, all the girls scurried out of the classroom, but Boli dared not to leave her corner. Her head still lowered, she kept on sobbing. When the school and the school bell rang, all girls scurried. It means rushed. All other girls rushed out of the classroom, but Boli still does not have courage to get up from her corner. Boli, the teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. In all her life, she had never been called like that. It touched her heart. Get up, said the teacher. It was not a command, but just a friendly suggestion. Boli got up. And the teacher called her. Teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. Before this, she had never heard someone calling her in this kind tune. Then teacher told her to get up. She felt like it was not a command but just a friendly request, and she got up too. Now tell me your name. Sweat broke out of her whole body. Would her stammering tongue again disgrace her for the sake of this kind woman? However, she decided to make an effort. She had such a soothing voice, she would not laugh at her. The teacher asked Boli to say her name again, but because of fear, sweat was flowing out of her entire body. Then she decided to make an effort to say her name, at least for the sake of that teacher, that kind teacher. Because the voice of the teacher was so soft and soothing, she was so confident that she would not laugh at her. Bo, 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 she began to stammer. Well done, the teacher encouraged her. Come, now the full name. Bo, bo, Boli. At last she was able to say it and felt relieved, as if it was a great achievement. And again she started to try saying her name, but again she stammered. Bo, bo. Even then the teacher did not get mad of her. She encouraged her, saying, well done. Then again, she asked her to say her full name. Finally, Boli said her full name. And she was so relieved, as if she did something great, like a great achievement. She felt it like a great achievement. Well done. The teacher patted her affectionately and said, put the fear out of your heart and you will be able to speak like everyone else. Boli looked up as if to ask really, yes, it would be very easy. You just come to school every day. Will you come? Boli nodded. No, say it aloud. Yes. And Boli herself was astonished that she had been able to say it. And the teacher appreciated her patting on her shoulder, and she said that get your fear out of you so that you would be able to speak like everyone. Speak fluently and clearly like everyone. Boli looked up her as if she is asking really. The teacher said, Yes, it would happen if you regularly come to school. And she asked, will you come to school regularly? Boli nodded her head, but the teacher said her to say it aloud. And Boli said yes. Boli was so surprised. Astonishment means surprise. She was so shocked that she was able to say that. Didn't I tell you? Now take this book. The book was full of nice pictures, and the pictures were in color. Dog, cat, goat, horse, parrot, tiger, and a cow just like Lakshmi. And with each and every picture was a word in big, big black letters. And then the teacher gave Boli a book and said her to read that. The book was so colorful, and there was pictures of lots of animals like a dog, cat, horse, parrot, tiger, and cow just like their Lakshmi. And with every picture there was a word with big black letters. In 1 month you will be able to read this book. Then I will get you a bigger book, then a still bigger one. In time you will be more learned than anyone else in the village. And she said Boli that she would be able to read this book in 1 month, and then she will give her still larger book and then still larger book. And she also said that if you do all this, you will be the most learned person in the village than everyone else. Then no one will ever be able to laugh at you. People will listen to you with respect, and you will be able to speak without the slightest stammer. Understand? Now you go home and come back tomorrow early. Come back early tomorrow morning. And then she also said that if you are the most learned person in the village, no one will make fun of you, and everyone will respectively speak with you. Then she said, Boli to go to home and come back tomorrow. Boli felt as if suddenly all the bells in the village temple were ringing, and the trees in front of the schoolhouse had blossomed to big red flowers. Her heart was troubling with a new hope and a new life. After hearing the teacher's words, Boli was feeling like all the bells in the village temples were ringing, and the flowers in front of her school and house were blossomed into big red flowers, and her heart was full of hope, and she felt it as if it's a new life. As the years passed, the village had become a small town. The little primary school became a high school. There were now a cinema theater under a shed and a cotton ginning machine. The mail train began to stop at their railway station. And many years passed. As the years passed, Boli would have been grown up too. And that village developed into a small town. And there was theaters and... There was a cotton ginning mill. Cotton ginning mill is a place where cotton is converted into thread. And the mail train started to stop at their station too. One night after dinner, Ramalal said to his wife, "Then shall I accept Bishamba's proposal?" "Yes, certainly," his wife said. "Boli will be lucky to get such a well-to-do bridegroom. A big shop, house full, and a house of his own, and I hear several thousand in the bank. Moreover, he is not asking for any dowry." One night, Ramalal and his wife was discussing about Bishamba's proposal to Boli, and Ramalal asked his wife. That can I accept this proposal? And his wife said yes, Boli would be so lucky to get such a groom as Bishambanath had a big shop and his own house, and she also heard that She also heard that he was having lots of money in his bank and he was not even asking for dowry. "That's right, but he is not so young. You know, almost the same age as I am. He also limps. Moreover, the children from his first wife are quite grown up." But Ramlal was quite worried because Bishambhanath was same age as him, and he has limps. Limps means he had difficulties in walking. He had difficulties in walking properly, and the children from his first wife was also been quite grown up. So what does it matter? His wife replied, 45 or 50, it is not a great age for men. We are lucky that he is from another village and does not know about her pockmarks and lack of sense. If we don't accept this proposal, she may remain unmarried all her life. Ramlal was worried, but his wife said that it's not a big age for a man, and they were lucky that Bishambhar was not in their village and he don't know about Boli's pockmarks and lack of sense. And she also said that if they miss this proposal, Boli would be unmarried all her life. "Yes, but I wonder what Boli will say. What will that witless one say? She is like a dumb cow." "Maybe you are right," muttered Ramlal. In the corner of the courtyard, Boli lay awake on her cot, listening to her parents' whispered conversation. And Ramlal again got a question that what would Boli say of this proposal and Bishambhanath. But his mother said, "What will that fool say? He is like a dump. She is like a dump cow." And then Ramlal muttered that, "Yeah, you're right." But Boli was lying outside the house in a bed, and she was listening to her parents' conversation. Bishambhanath was well-to-do grocer. He came with a big party of friends and relations with him for the wedding. A brass band playing a popular tune from an Indian film headed the procession, with the bridegroom riding a decorated horse. Ramlal was overjoyed to see such pomp and splendor. He had never dreamed that his four daughters would have such a grand wedding. Boli's elder sister, who had come for the occasion, were envious of her luck. And the marriage day came, and Bishambhanath came with a lot of party of his friends and relations, and the musical band was playing a famous tune of Indian film, and Bishambhanath came on a well-decorated horse. Ramlal was so happy to see such a splendor, and he had never thought that his fourth daughter Boli would get such an opportunity and a grand wedding, and Boli's sister was also jealous of her luck. Envious means jealous. Jealous of her luck. When the auspicious moment came, the priest said, "Bring the bride." Boli, clad in a red silken bridal dress, was led to the bride's place near the scared fire. And a particular moment came and the priest said to bring the bride and Boli was there too. She was in a nice red bridal dress and she was also wearing a veil on her head. And she sat near Bishambas in front of the fire. Garland the bride, one of his friends promoted Bishambanath. The bridegroom lifted the garland of yellow marigold. A woman slipped back the silken veil from the bride's face. Bishamba took a quick glance. And someone said Bishambar, some friend said Bishambar to garland the bride, and Bishambar took a garland of marigold to garland Boli, and a woman standing behind the Boli took off the veil from her face, and Bishambar had time to take a glance of her, time to see her. The garland remained possessed in his hand. The bride slowly pulled down the veil over her face. "Have you seen her?" said Bishambar to friend next to him. "She had pockmarks on her face." "So what? You're not young either." "Maybe, but I'm not. If I'm to marry her, her father must give me 5,000 rupees." And he did not garland Boli still. He stopped there and Boli pulled veil on her face. Then Bishambar said to the friend next to him that Boli has pockmarks on her face, but his friend said that it's what if she has pockmarks? You are not young either. But Bishambanath said that if this marriage should continue, her father should give me 5,000 rupees. Ramlal went and placed his turban his honor at Bishambar's feet. "Do not humiliate me so. Take 2,000 rupees. "No, 5,000. Or we go back. Keep your daughter. Be a little considerate, please. If you go back, I can never show my face in the village." Then out with 5,000. And Ramlal went and placed his turban in Bishambanath's feet and he requested Bishambanath to take 2,000 rupees. But Bishambar did not accept that. He said that I just need 5,000 rupees. But Boli's father said that, Bishambar said that I just want 5,000 rupees or else we will return back to home. But then Ramlal said that if you return back, if the marriage stops, we can never show our face to other villagers. And Bishambar said that then give 5,000 rupees. Tears streaming down his face, Ramlal went in, opened the safe and counted out the notes. He placed the bundle at the bridegroom's feet. On Bishambar's greedy face appeared a triumphant smile. And there is no other go for Ramlal, so he rushed to his house and opened the safe. Safe means locker. Safe is locker, and he took a bundle of money out of the safe and kept on Bishambar's feet, and Bishambar's face had a victorious smile as if he won something big. And give me the garland, he announced. Once again the veil was slipped back from the bride's face, but this time her eyes were not downcast. She was looking up, looking straight at his prospective husband, and in her eyes there was neither anger nor hate, only cold contempt. And Vishwambhanath announced that, "Give me the garland and let the marriage continue. But again the veil from Boli's face slipped, but this time she was not facing the she was straightly seeing her prospective husband. Prospective means future. She was straightly seeing her future husband, and but that time her eyes were not seeing down. She was straightly seeing Vishwambhanath's face, who is her future husband. Vishwambhanath raised the garland to place it round the bride's neck, but before he could do, Boli had struck out like a streak lightning, and the garland was flung into the fire. She got up and threw away the veil, and Vishwambhanath raised his hand to garland the bride, but before he does it, Boli grabs it from his hand and threw it on the fire, and Boli gets up and threw her veil away too. "Pitaji," said Boli in clear loud voice, and her father, mother, sister, brother, relation and neighbors were startled to hear her speak without a slightest stammer. And Boli shouted, "Pitaji, Pitaji," means father. She said it in a clear voice, so all her relatives, family, neighbors were all shocked to hear her speaking without a slightest stammer. Stammer means some difficulties in talking. "Pitaji, take back your money. I'm not going to marry this man." Ramlal was thunder-shocked. The guest began to whisper, "So shameless, so ugly and so shameless." "Are you crazy?" shouted Ramlal. "You want to disgrace your family?" Okay. And Boli said her father to take back the money, and everyone was shocked. Ramlal was so shocked, and the guests began to murmur already. They started speaking like shameless girl, so shameless and so ugly girl. Then Ramlal shouted at Boli that, "Are you going crazy? What about a family respect? Have some regard for our Izzat. For the sake of your Izzat," said Boli, "I was willing to marry this lame old man, but I will not have such a mean, greedy and contemptible coward as my husband. I won't. And Boli replied that, "Just only for your respect, I accepted to marry this old man, but now I'm not willing to marry this greedy and mean man. I will not accept this coward as my husband," she said. "What a shameless girl. We all thought she was a harmless dumb cow." Boli turned violently to the old woman. "Yes, auntie, you are right. You all thought I was dumb driven cow. That's why you wanted to hand me over to this heartless creature. But now the dumb cow, the stammering fool, she is speaking. Do you want to hear more?" And one woman in that marriage said that, "What a shameless girl. We all thought that she is a dumb cow." After hearing that, Boli turned to her violently and started shouting at her, Yes, auntie, you are right. You all thought that I am a dumb cow, but a dumb cow and a fool is speaking. And she asked, do you want to hear more? Bishambhanath's grocer started to go back with his party. The confused bandsman thought it was the end of the ceremony and stuck up a closing song. Ramlal stood rooted to the ground, his head bowed low with the weight of grief and shame. The flames of the scared fire slowly died down. Everyone was gone. And Bishambhanath started to return with his party. And the musical band thought that this is the end of the wedding. And they closed it with a closing song. Ramlal bowed his head and was... Ramlal was ashamed and Ramlal lowered his head because of shame, and the flames of the sky, fire stopped too, and everyone was gone. Ramlal turned to Boli and said, "But what about you? No one will ever marry you now. What shall we do with you?" And Sulekha said in a voice that was calm and steady, "You don't worry, Pitaji. In your old age, I will serve you and mother and will teach in the same school where I learned so much." And everyone was gone. After that, Boli and Ramlal turned to Boli and asked, what are you going to do now? What are we going to do with you? Then Boli replied in a calm and steady voice that, "You don't worry, father. I will take care of you when you are old, and I will work in the same school and teach there where I learned so much." "Isn't that right, ma'am?" The teacher had all along stood in the corner watching the drama. "Yes, Boli, of course," she replied, and in her smiling eyes was a light of deep satisfaction that an artist feels when contemplating the completion of her masterpiece. And she asked her teacher, "Isn't it right, ma'am?" She asked her teacher that that the thing she have done was right or wrong. The teacher was standing all the time there. The teacher was standing all the time and watching this drama. And she also said this, "Yes, Boli, you're right." And she was so proud, and she was so proud to see her student being this bold and brave. She felt like what an artist feel when they complete their masterpiece. She felt same like that, and she was full of proud. She was so proud. And this is the end of the lesson. Thank you.
SRMJV is not just a school, it's a one-time experience.
VM Nagar, Tiruvallur,